We want to identify the coordinates or ordered pair for each of the points plotted on the coordinate plane. To do this, we need to remember that the horizontal axis is the x-axis and the vertical axis is the y-axis. So the coordinates for each point will consist of an x-coordinate and a y-coordinate. And then these are also called ordered pairs. So if we look at point A, to determine the x-coordinate, we just need to draw a segment straight to the x-axis. Here the x-coordinate would be positive 5, and then we draw a segment straight to the y-axis to identify the y-coordinate. So the y-coordinate is positive 6. So for point A, the x-coordinate is positive 5, and the y-coordinate is positive 6. And it has to be in this order. The x-coordinate always comes first, and the y-coordinate always comes second. So if we look at point B, the x-coordinate would be negative 3, and the y-coordinate would be positive 3. Again, this is the x-axis, and this is the y-axis. So point B has coordinates negative 3, positive 3. Now point C is a little bit different. Notice how it lies on the x-axis. So we can see the x-coordinate is going to be negative 6. And if we drew a segment straight to the y-axis, notice how it would intersect the y-axis right at 0. And that's because this point does not move up or down from the x-axis. So the y-coordinate is 0. Now let's take a look at point D down here in the third quadrant. We draw a segment straight to the x-axis. Notice how it intersects the x-axis at negative 7. If we draw a segment straight to the y-axis, it intersects the y-axis at negative 6. So the coordinates for point D would be negative 7, comma, negative 6. And then for point E, we go straight to the x-axis. It intersects the x-axis at positive 2. And if we draw a segment straight to the y-axis, intersects at negative 5. So the x-coordinate is positive 2, and the y-coordinate is negative 5. And for the last point, we have point F, which lies on the y-axis. So if we drew a segment straight to the x-axis, notice how it intersects the x-axis right at 0. So the x-coordinate is 0. And then we can see the y-coordinate would be positive 4. So notice how when the point lies on the y-axis, the x-coordinate is always going to be 0. And when a point lies on the x-axis, like point C, the y-coordinate will always be 0. And then one more thing that I do want to mention. There are four quadrants in the coordinate plane formed by the intersection of the two axes. This is the first quadrant. This is the second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. So in the first quadrant, both the x and the y coordinates are positive. In the second quadrant, the x coordinate is negative, the y coordinate is positive. Third quadrant, both coordinates are negative. And the fourth quadrant, the x-coordinate is positive, and the y-coordinate is negative. So point A is in quadrant 1, point B is in quadrant 2, point D is in quadrant 3, point E is in quadrant 4, and then notice that point C and F lie on the axes, and they are not considered to be in a quadrant. Point C lies on the x-axis, and point F lies on the y-axis. I hope you found this helpful.